Yeah, what's going on, everybody? It's iPodKingCarter, the Superman of YouTube. After going 2-0 in Chicago, we coming back to Dime City with a chip on our shoulder. Before we get into the game, let me tell you guys a few things. Ye did not go back to China. Actually, Ye is out 1 to 2 weeks with back spasms, but he wasn't showing up in an injury report, so I had to go all the way to the team roster and figure out what was going on. But other than that, man, we back in Dime City. We got your rep code, so we good, man. Ye, we gonna wait till you come back in the next round of the playoffs, hopefully. But until then, man, we gotta show what we got against the Bulls in Dime City. Let's go.
Eastern Conference Finals action. Coy in a 2-0 series thus far. Who will take game three? We're gonna find out here live on 2K Sports, bringing you the NBA playoffs. Kevin Harlan along with Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg. Great to be with you. It's the Chicago Bulls and the Philadelphia 76ers.
I decided to mock the Bulls real quick, so I put on a different pair of the LeBron 9s and the Bulls colors. I wanted to show them that it ain't no fear in Dime City, man. I'm wearing they colors on my feet, and trust me, they gonna be bleeding red. But check me out, 63 points per game, 12 assists, 7 steals, and I'm almost shooting 60% from the field. Goodness gracious. But in the first play of the game, yes, the very first play, I'm pulling out my patented work, man. I'm pulling out that PHI alley. I'm going to try and make it work to perfection, even though I got bumped twice by D-Rose. That's what happens. The clock is winding down, but it ain't no fear, because Paul George going to go get it, baby. That's all. All I got to do is throw it up there, man. Somebody going to go get it. And with him cutting to the basket, we got a good chance. Now, after Dang missed that layup, we out on a break. I hit my boy Booker. I see him cutting to the basket. I got eyes in the back of my head, man. And you know what he did? Put his balls all in Brewer face. But check it out, man. Look at Paul George from behind Noah. I don't think D-Rose saw him, but check me out with the elevator. You already know what it is, man. We on an 8-0 run. Let's go. Now, coming down on this offensive play, you already know what I want to do, man. I want to run my patented play one more time. I just got to let him know that we here. The three-pointer wasn't going to work, so guess what? I throw it right back up. You know, I got choices in that play right there. I could shoot the three, or I could just throw it like I just did. Now, check out Paul George hesitating. Now, check us out, man. My boy Booker didn't get bumped on his way to the basket, so he gets an and-one dunk from my lead pass. Look at Carlos Boozer. He mad. Go sit your behind down on that bench, man. You're bad. Now, check out D-Rose. You see me about to put the intense D on, right? Now, look what happens when I do that. As soon as I put on my intense D and I try to follow D-Rose, I get fouled out. Now, that always happens when I put my turbo and my intense D on, which is R2 and L2. Whenever you're doing that, trust me, you do not want to get caught in the screen that's already playing it, because you will get called for that personal foul. It is what it is, though. But my team, they holding their own. We up a nice little amount right now. I decided, you know, to just sit back, relax, not sim it, you know, too fast. I want to see what my team can actually do. And they holding their own. Let's get into the second quarter, y'all. Now, we out on the break. See that hop, step, fake? I tried to get it to my boy Booker. I thought he was going to dunk on somebody, but you know me. I pull for three and it's cash. That's what I'm doing nowadays, man. I'm starting to shoot more threes, realizing that my attribute is kind of high to shoot threes, so why not do it? It's only right. You know, a lot of people, they want to see jump shots from me anyway, so I can give you guys a couple spoilers. You feel me? But check out my boy Kmart. He can shoot the three for damn sure. You know what I'm saying? Why not pass it to him? Now, we up big right now. We trying to hold the lead. We not putting the brakes on, man. We are putting on the pressure. Check out my boy Rose trying to switch on defense. That's what you get. You feel me? Now, check out Dang pulling for three. He don't even care about his own teammates. I know he was supposed to swing it at least one more time. But you see me right here. My boy Landry Fields hit me for the jump shot. I get hit with the little stupid animation. Luckily, I'm not injured, right? You feel me? But we coming down on the fast break. Boy Watson get hit with the stupid animation, and I get the crazy dunk. You know I'm going to the line for one more. Let's get into halftime, y'all.
Conference finals keep on rolling. Now for a halftime breakdown presented by HP.
For the Philadelphia 76ers, they have the lead against Chicago. They're trying to string together their third win in a row in this series. They felt the impact of Trevor Booker. He has 13 points, just as important. He's been shooting with excellent efficiency. And the Bulls going all out. They've limited the second chance buckets. They've been crashing the defensive glass, playing big on the defensive end. Derrick Rose is making his presence felt early. He's up to 14 points and is also working on the other end of the floor. Nice defensive work. These two have set the benchmark so far tonight, leading their teams in first half scoring. That's it here. Now let's send you back to Kevin, Steve, Clark, and Doris for the start of the third quarter.
All right, after I get subbed in real quick, you already know what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to run on a break, but Paul George wasn't having it, so you know what I do, man. I see my boy Booker on the other side, and I seen Noah cheating, so I had to hit him for the assist. Now, check me out trying to get a little reset on the play. Got my boy Booker set in a nice little screen. He going to the rim for the and one. Boozer pissed off. He's snapping. He got to go sit his behind down back on the bench. His bad. Take your baldy over there, man. Don't you got hair now, by the way? Hey, man, what can I say, man? 2K is so funny. Now, you see me about to try to run my patented play one more time, but with somebody different. I want to run it with Williams this time. Now, as you can see, my boy Booker hit me with a nice little screen. Now, Watson got hit in a crazy animation, so I'm pulling. It's cash, you feel me? I told y'all I wasn't going to stop shooting these threes when I had the chance. Now, check out Dang. How you know that the ball was coming? That's all I want to know. Your back was turned. Come on, man. Come on, 2K. Now, you see me on a fast break. Did you see that speed burst at half court? Ew. And I'm dunking on Ronnie Brewer. Ew. Did y'all see that? Y'all didn't see that speed burst, though. All you got to do is, man, just run it up to the half court line, hit that little speed burst trigger, and switch hands. Crazy. Now, you see me, you know, stopping on the dime, making sure everything was good, but Williams ain't want to hit the shot. But check out Brewer on a fast break. It looked like he was kind of mad. It looked like he don't want to give up. You feel me? But it's all good, man. He going to the line. He dunked on Paul. It's cool. Now, Boykins, thank you for hitting me. I appreciate that, sir. Now, I'm going all the way to the rim. All the way to the rim for the elevator.
Now as we get going here in the fourth, let's send it over to Doris Burke for our Sprite Spark.
Well, Kevin, our spark of the game in this one, the stretch by the 76ers. It seems they went into the locker room and came out with some answers because their defense has been airtight in this last half. The whole atmosphere of the game.
All right, look at Rose trying to show out on me real quick in the paint. I'm giving him every bump animation I got. Luckily, they gave it a no call, but check out Errol Boykins giving Evan Turner the full court pass with the dunk and one on D-Rose. So you know what that means, man. D-Rose got to go sit down on the bench. I'm loving it. You feel me? I'm not the one fouling this guy out. I'm telling y'all. Booker fouled him out of the second quarter. Paul George fouled him out of the third quarter. And it looked like my boy Evan Turner fouled him out of the fourth. Now, check me out with the reverse dunk. Now, with that dunk right there, I received the pass in the paint, but it looked like I took a little bit too many steps. We might have to get a little replay of this. Hold up. Here go the slow-mo cam real quick. Hold on. All right, I caught the pass. See how many steps I take. 1, 2, 1, 2. All right, I took 4 steps. But can I get a continuation, people? I know in last video you guys were telling me, hey, you took way too many steps. Hey, that's what happens. But check me out going past Bogans, I believe that is. I was showing out on him. But check it out. We out on a fast break. But it's not really a fast break. It's just me taking control of my team. I came down slow. I knew that my boy Paul George was on a break and he was trailing, so I decided to slow it up and get it to him. Now, check out D-Rose. He's back in the game. He's mad. He's pissed off he couldn't play, so he hit me with every series of moves he got in his arsenal, and he hit the jump shot. But it was great defense by me, though. I ain't gonna lie about that one. I'm sticking the best defense I can on an overpowered player in 2K. Real talk. Now, I don't know how Dane got that rebound, but we're not going to talk about that. I thought that basketball fundamentals was boxing out, but I guess that doesn't happen. But D-Rose goes in for the layup. He laid me up. I'm telling you, he wants revenge. You feel me? D-Rose, he has to get his. You feel me? Even if he's not in the game for that long, D-Rose got to get at least 20 points, at least. Now, check this out. He decided to throw an assist, but guess who was the recipient? Boozer. And now we need a timeout. Now, I'm trying to give D-Rose all I got, hitting with the nice step back with the jump shot. That should have been cash, but it don't always fall. But check out Noah with the full length pass to Brewer, and Brewer gets the and-one foul. See? Never give up, man. The computer never gives up no matter how hard or how bad you're beating them, yo. They just never give up. Check it out. Look at Pargo with the nice. Oh, that was my fault. Yeah, that was my fault. Yeah, I thought he was going to do an up and under move, and, you know, I thought it was coming right there. But, like I said, man, never think that the computer is giving up, seriously. But we're still up five right now, you know, after you hit that foul line shot. We up five. That's all that matter. It's only 15 seconds left. You know, as long as they put me on the line, the Nels is going to get in the coffin regardless. You feel me? You can have whatever type of coffin you want. You can have wooden, you can have metal chrome, you can have any coffin. I got the nails for it. You know what I'm saying? I might use that nail gun from The Wire. Not too many of y'all might get that. I've been watching that series lately, man. Watching all five seasons of that joint over and over and over. I love that TV show. But back to this basketball, man. I put the nails in the coffin. They need the timeout. The boy Pargo comes back in the game. It's all good. I ain't worried about it. Now, Boozer, we paid him off early in the game. Right before he got on the flight, we offered him $25K. So, you know, he's throwing the game right now. It's like, no. But I don't know why he dribbled it out.
On that one. So, the 76ers win it. They pulled off this win, Clark, with respectable performances on both ends of the floor.
Yeah, I think it was just really a nice overall effort, Kevin.
And that about wraps it up for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke, and the whole crew from 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan saying so long, and thanks for watching the NBA Eastern Conference Finals. Now let's take a look at the Jordan Player of the Game.
Dime City Music. Dime City Music. Dime City Music. Dime City Music. Dime City. Dime Dime City. 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 City feels, Dime City feels, Dime Dime City feels, Dime City feels, Dime Dime City feels, Dime City feels, Dime Dime City feels. Let's go, let's go. They can't stop Dime City. Let's go, let's go. They can't stop Dime City.
That win put your team up 3-0 and on the verge of moving on to the next round. How do you feel right now? Is a sweep on your mind?
Most of these guys will probably tell you that it isn't. That they're just focused on playing good basketball and blah, 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 blah. But let me assure you, that's all we're thinking about. We just want to move on and get out of this round as soon as possible. So we'll be doing whatever we can to make that sweep a reality. A little more rest, a little more time scouting your next opponent. It's a good thing all around, so you better believe a sweep is on our minds.